Have you seen students write 101 as 1001 or 25 as 205? Children commonly make this mistake when they have not understood the concept of place value properly. In this video, I'll explain how to use the place value fan to teach place value with large numbers. Before you start teaching large numbers, it's important to revise the concept of place value with smaller numbers. So start by writing a number on the board, say 275, and ask students to show that number using the place value house. In case you are not familiar with the place value house, please look up the video for the place value house. For a quick recap, a bead stands for units, a rod stands for tens, and a flat stands for hundreds. So students will show 275 using two flats, seven rods, and five beads. Now, underline one of the digits, say 2, and ask them, what is the value of 2 in this number? So, what is the place value of 2? Since there are 2 hundreds, the place value of 2 is 200. Show them the expanded form of 275 as 200 plus 70 plus 5. Now, move on to teaching this concept using the place value fan. Let us look at the place value fan. As you can see in the place value fan, there are places for units, tens, hundreds, and also for thousands, ten thousands, and lakhs. When you teach them to use the place value fan, also teach children to use verbal clues in the number. 200. Tell them that the digit always comes before the place in which it sits. So 200, so 2 will be in the place of hundreds. So write 2 in the house of hundreds. 70 means 7 tens. So in the house of tens, write 7. And 5. So write 5 in the house of units. Now we have not used the other houses, so just turn them away so that we get the number 275. Give them another number, a bigger number this time. Say 1054. Show children how it is very easy to erase off the numbers written on this fan with a sketch pen. Ask them to erase the previous number and then write the new number, 1054. Again, teach them how to recognize the verbal clues. 1000. So 1 in the house of thousands. 50. 5 in the house of tens. 4. That is in the house of units. Ask them what will be in the house of hundreds. There's no mention of that, so keep that blank. Now, turn away all those places which are blank. In this case, the lakhs, the ten thousands, as well as the hundreds. When you turn it, you will notice that there is a zero in place of hundreds. So the number 1054 is 1054. Give students a lot of practice in showing numbers using the place value fan, especially numbers that have zeros in them. Here is a sample that you can use. Let's take a new number. 1,002,506. Again, emphasize to students to make use of the verbal clues. 1 lakh, so one in the house of lakhs. 2,000, so two in the house of thousands. 500, so five in the house of hundreds. And 6, so 6 in the units. Turn away all those places where we have not put any numbers and which are blank. This is how the number looks like. 1,2,506. Give students a lot of practice with such numbers. It is a good idea to ask students how many zeros are there in a lakh. Ask them to write 1 in the house of lakhs and then turn away all the places. Now, how many zeros in the house of lakhs? Give them a lot of practice with this. 10,000s, 1,000, so that they know how many zeros are there in a particular number. Students also make mistakes while reading numbers. Let's take the same example we used last time. 1,2,506. If you write this number on the board and ask them to read it, children may have difficulties, but the place value fan can help them till they are confident of reading numbers correctly. Guide students to use the place value fan, and the way to use it is to start writing from the right to the left, the way the Arabs write. So first write the house of units, or start with the first digit on the right in the house of units. So it will be 6, 0, 5, 2, 0, 1. Now ask them to make use of the places to read the number. 1 lakh, 2,000, 506. Give them a lot of practice in writing the number names. The back side of the fan can be used to write the name. This is one example. 1 lakh, 2,000, 500, and 6. Ask students to hold up their fan this way when they show the number name, or even when they show the numbers. When the whole class shows this, it is very easy for the teacher to identify those students who have not understood the concept and focus and help them out. This fan has helped many students to quickly understand large numbers. Make the most of it.